Hello there. My name is Mrs. Aurora Santa Ana, and today is the fourth Sunday of Easter. We are still in the season of Easter, but before we start the liturgy, I have a short game for you. We have here different kinds of thieves and robbers. Thieves and robbers. What does a bank robber do?
A person who takes money from a bank.
Okay, a person who takes money from a bank. Okay, and you don't want to be that, right? How about the carjacker? What does it do?
For people who steal cars.
Oh, steals cars. Okay, how about this one right here? Highwayman. What does a highwayman do?
Someone who takes things from travelers.
Things from the travelers. Okay, how about the shoplifter?
Someone who steals the merchandise in the stores.
You're right. And how about the embezzler? Have you heard the word embezzler before?
The person who steals money from their employer.
Yes, okay. So these are all bad guys, right? And we don't want to be these people. But today, in today's liturgy, we will learn about the parable. What is parable? You will learn about that. And do you know that there are false teachers? Who are the false teachers? And do you know that there are things and situations that steal us from Jesus? What are those? And how can Jesus shepherd us for the better? Okay, so that's what's gonna talk about today. And before we start, I would like to invite you to take a moment of silence so we can remember our sins and ask for God's forgiveness. You will answer the prayer with, "Lord, you are our shepherd and we belong to you." Can we all say it, please?
Lord, you are our shepherd and we belong to you.
Lord, you are our shepherd and we belong to you. You call us by name. Let's pray.
Lord, you are my shepherd. We belong to you.
We follow you because we belong to you. Lord, you are our shepherd and we belong to you. Response?
Lord, you are our shepherd and we belong to you.
Let's now proceed to the first reading.
In today's first reading, the people of Jerusalem want to know what they can do to make up for their part in Jesus' death. Listen to how the Apostle Peter answers their question.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of the Pentecost, Peter stood with 11 apostles and spoke in a loud and clear voice to the crowd. Everyone in Israel should know this for now, that God has made Jesus both Lord and Christ. Even though you put him to death on a cross, when the people heard this, they were very upset. They asked Peter and other apostles, "Friends, what shall we do?" Peter said, "Turn back to God. Be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins will be forgiven. Then you will be given the Holy Spirit. Then promise is for you and your children. It is for everyone our Lord God will choose, no matter where they live." Peter told the people many other things as well. Then he said, "I beg you to save ourselves from what will happen to all these evil people." On that day, about 3,000 believed this message and were baptized. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let's now proceed to the responsorial psalm.
The response is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You, Lord, are my shepherd. I will never be in need. You lead me to rest in fields of green grass. You lead me to streams of peaceful water, and you refresh my life. Response:
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You are true to your name, and you lead me along the right paths. I may walk through valleys as dark as death, but I won't be afraid. You are with me, and your shepherd's rod makes me feel safe. Response:
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Your kindness and love will always be with me each day of my life, and I will live forever in your house, Lord. Response?
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Okay. In today's gospel, Jesus says we are his sheep and he is our shepherd.
Let's sing the Alleluia. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you for certain that there are thieves and robbers climb over the fence instead of going in through the gate to the sheep pen. But the gatekeeper opens the gate for the shepherd, and he goes in and through it. The sheep know their shepherd's voice. He calls each one of them by name and leads them out. When he has led out all of his sheep, he walks in front of them. And they follow because they know his voice. The sheep will not follow strangers. They don't recognize a stranger's voice and they run away. Jesus told the Peter this story, but they did not understand what he was talking about. Then Jesus said, I tell you for certain that I am the gate for the sheep. Everyone who came before me was a thief or a robber. And the sheep did not listen to any of them. I am the gate. All who come in through me will be saved. Through me, they will come and go and find pasture. A thief comes only to rob, kill, and destroy. I came so that everyone would have life and have it in its fullest. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
All right, so we just heard about the gospel for today's reading, and it's about a parable. Parables are short stories told by Jesus to teach us a lesson. Now, in the story, in the parable, he mentions something about the shepherd. What does the shepherd do? The shepherd takes care of the sheep, okay? And the sheep, they listen to the voice of the shepherd. They follow the shepherd because they have that special connection. They know what the shepherd's voice sounds like. Now, there are also some strangers who try to steal the sheep away from the shepherd. Now, the strangers, when they call out the sheep, they didn't listen. They didn't follow the strangers because they don't know that stranger's voice. They're not familiar with the voice of that stranger, unlike the voice of the shepherd who takes care of them every single day. We will also learn about the detractors. Detractors are also the strangers here. Now let's compare the parable of Jesus to our lives, okay? Now, the detractors here, like what we played, they are like the carjackers, they're like the bank robbers, they're like the embezzlers, and they're like the shoplifters in our lives. Now, how can that be? Where do we see all these thieves and robbers in our lives, okay? Because we don't go to the mall by ourselves, but we do. We see a whole lot of robbers and a lot of thieves every single day. So we need to watch, okay? We need to be alert. And this is why Jesus was telling us this parable so we know. And we should be careful, okay? So now, the shepherd in the parable is Jesus. Jesus, because we follow his voice, we listen to his gospel, and we follow his teachings. Okay, he takes care of us because he loves us. Now, who are the sheep? The sheep, okay, the sheep will be us. Us, the believers. We go to church because we believe in Jesus. Okay, so pardon my church right there. I should put a big cross. Let me put the cross bigger. Okay, so that's going to be us, the sheep. Do we listen to Jesus' voice? Yes, we do, right? That's why we're doing this children's liturgy, because we thirst for the teachings of Jesus. And then we, the believers, go to church and we are families, right? We have our own families right here. So the believers have their own homes and we keep our family intact. We keep believing to Jesus. Okay, this is the whole family and we live in our homes. And our homes are the little churches. And that's what Jesus wants us to do. That's what God wants us to do. To keep practicing what we learn from Jesus in our own homes. We treat each other nicely. Okay, we respect our parents. We do our job as children. And we just be respectful. Now, we talked about the thieves and the robbers. Who are the thieves and the robbers in our lives? Ooh, let's talk about that, okay? So like the parable, there were strangers who tried to steal the sheep from the shepherd. But the thieves and the robbers are stealing the children or the believers from their home, okay? What do? There are false teachers. Do you know that false teachers exist? Yes, in the time of Jesus, the false teachers were the leaders, the Jewish leaders, who always find fault in Jesus' teachings. They always tried to make his teachings look like it's wrong, okay? There was one time when Jesus was out and he made the blind man see. He cured the blind man. And that was on the Lord's day. So the Jewish leaders said, they were telling people, how can you sin on the Lord's day? Is it sinful to help other people on the Lord's day? On a Sunday, on a Sabbath day, are we not allowed? Are we not allowed to do some good things? I think it is right? It is just right to observe and celebrate the Lord's Day by doing good things for other people, right? But in the past, during Jesus' times, these false teachers were telling other people, the sheep, the believers, that he is not the Messiah, that he is doing something wrong, okay? All right, so we put it here. But right now we have the thieves and the false teachers in our lives. Who are the false teachers in our lives? So let me put here. Okay, boys and girls, you have to be very careful with what you see and what you hear. Because not everything that you see, not everything that you hear are correct or are right, okay? So where do we find the false teachers? TV shows. Okay, you watch TV shows, but be very careful, be very vigilant, because most of the TV shows, they always show only the smart people are right, or only those who are beautiful or handsome and strong, they make them look good, okay? And in the TV commercials, they always show like nice outfits for the girls, but sometimes they're not appropriate. So you need to be very careful, because Jesus wants us to respect our bodies, because our bodies, especially women, the girls, we need to respect our bodies, because our bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit. And the boys, we need to respect the girls also, okay? But for us to be respected, boys and girls, we need to dress appropriately. Okay, we know there are some women, there are a lot of women, there are a lot of girls who dress like inappropriately, but that doesn't mean we need to be just like them, okay? Because we follow what Jesus tells us to do. We follow what's in the gospel, okay? Respect other people, but that doesn't mean we need to be like them. So they are like the thieves and the robbers, because they make things look right when it's not right. Okay? So be vigilant about that. And technology. Are you always on your phone? Always on your game? You know that technology can destroy our family. Because we want to spend time with our family, but what do? We're always on our phone. We're always playing a game. We'd rather play games with our other friends or online friends friends instead of what? Spending time with our family. And it destroys relationships, okay? And we don't want that. So the thieves and the robbers, they're trying to steal us away from our family. So we have to be very careful about that, okay? Let me tell you a short story. Most of the time, sometimes technology destroys family and relationship. But last weekend, I'll tell you a story, because two of my children are grown and they don't live with us anymore. The two girls are here back from school because, you know, schools are closed. So they're with me. They're with us right now. And so we normally do our thing like online. They watch the mass online by themselves. But last Sunday, I was really surprised because it was a few minutes before church time. The two older ones started calling. And I said, why are they calling right now? It's about to start. The mass is about to start. And so they said, we can watch mass together. And I'm like, that is such a cool idea. I didn't think about that. I never thought about us watching mass and participating and attending mass and hearing Father Paul and Father Dan at the same time. So for the first time, again, in this COVID-19 season, we went to church together as a whole family. Did that break our family? No. Did that break our relationship? No. We use technology to put us all together. And that's what we want to do, boys and girls, okay? So try to keep an eye and be careful with the thieves and robbers in our lives, okay? We want to be careful. Be alert. Not everything that you see, not everything that you hear on TV, on commercials, and whatever, wherever, they're not right, okay? Be very careful. God gave us this brain to keep us smart and help us make wise decisions. We should know what is right and what is wrong, and we always follow what is right. We need to listen to our shepherd, and who is our shepherd? It's Jesus, okay? And we follow what is right, okay? All right. All right, so let's now proceed to the profession of faith.
Respond to each question with the words, I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, who chose you to be his very own through the sacrament of baptism?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, who came that you might have life and live it to the fullest?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, who was given to you as a helper and guide on the day of your baptism?
I do.
Let's now move to the prayers of the faithful. As people dedicated to learning and living by the teachings of Christ, let us pray for the needs of our church, our world, and ourselves. Our response to each petition will be, Shepherd us, O Lord. Can you say that for me, please?
Shepherd us, O Lord.
Loving God, lead along the right path for our Pope Francis and all the bishops and priests and religious brothers and sisters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Shepherd us, O Lord.
Loving God, lead along the path for the people who create the TV shows, the ads, and the movies that we see every day. We pray.
Shepherd us, O Lord.
Lead us along the right path for all the members of our parish, we pray.
Shepherd us, O Lord.
And like what we always do, we always pray for the medical team as they find cure to the coronavirus and to heal the world. And also we ask God to please bless all the sick and all those who are prone for illness. And we also want to share a special prayer for our friend, Miss Juanita, in her new home. May she find new friends and a new prayer group. And also for Father Dan and Father Paul, as they celebrate their priesthood. You know, Jesus loves us. God loves us. He gave us Father Dan, and that's a great, great blessing. But guess what? Because Jesus loves us so much, he doubled the blessing because he gave us Father Paul, okay? And so we pray,
Shepherd us, O Lord.
And in the silence of our hearts, God knows what's in our heart. We take a moment to ask God our petition. And we pray to the Lord.
Shepherd us, O Lord.
And because Jesus loves us, we will end the session with the song. And this is the chorus. I want you to learn it for me. Say, yes, Jesus loves us, and we will do it 3 times. The Bible tells me so. When we say, yes, you do this, Jesus is always like this, loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. We'll do that 3 times, and the Bible tells me so. Come on, my family. Let's go. Come on. All right. Get in here. Okay, join us in singing, okay?
And dancing.
All right.
And dancing.
Oh, hold on. And we will be dancing. Let me put this up. Can you kneel down to Saria, please? Okay. Okay. All right. Ready? Uh-huh. Jesus loves us, okay? Sing with us and dance with us. All right.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones who belong to Him, they are weak, but we are strong.
He is strong. Yes.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Okay.
Jesus loves me, He who died. Heaven's gate to open wide. He will wash away my sins. Let His little child come in.
All right. Yes, Jesus loves me.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
Okay. You can dance. Come on, guys, you can dance. Come on. Okay. This is our last one. Yes, Jesus loves me.
Yes, Jesus loves me.
All right.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. The Bible tells me so.
For joining us, okay? We had fun. Bye.
Bye.